Welcome to Advanced Thermal Solutions. Right now we're with Dr. Kaveh Azar.
Hello.
Thanks everybody for joining us. Kaveh, we've got a whole series of interesting shaped extrusions and metal here. Are some of these heat sinks, or what would you use these for?
John, these are called LED heat sinks that are specifically designed for LEDs. Here, for instance, you can see some large extrusions that we have already designed and extruded for the purpose of being able to apply it to different LEDs. Here is a larger version of it. It's a very heavy extrusion, but
that's giant.
You can see that how we've utilized this. This is a very, very complex extrusion to fabricate, but we've been able to, through our manufacturing arm, fabricate these for our customers in the LED market.
You wouldn't use it this size, right? You'd chop it up or something to different size lengths?
Exactly. You're exactly right. Here is a couple of examples, for instance, that the extrusion is cut to size, where the LED goes in the bottom here, John, and the heat is conducted from the base into the back, and then eventually convected off. These go on the LEDs that can go inside the ceiling, onto a wall, for spot lighting type of applications. You can see a variety of different designs that we've done.
Is that an LED we've got here?
And exactly.
Like they put them together.
This is an actual light that's sold off the shelf right now in the market. And it's got three LEDs, and it's got a convection that's opposite of what you saw in here, John. This one was a straight extrusion. This is a circular one.
I see.
It's just a different thermal need, the different needs that we have for the cooling purpose. And the objective is to make sure that the LED lights are as cool as possible, because of the fact the excess heat is going to impact the result. There's a different applications, like this one, for instance. You can see with some little bit of cosmetic, because this shows, and the customer likes it, something that's different. You can see that it's got the silver tips, and as far as the fins are concerned. Yet the LED goes in here, the electronics goes, the wire that supports the electronics goes through here, and from here it goes to your wall and what have you. Very similar to what you see in this one.
Oh, I see, with the wires coming out the back like that.
Yeah.
And we have some flat heat sinks as well. Are these also used for different kinds of LED purposes?
Absolutely. The LEDs, you saw one example of a spot or downlight, as it's commonly called, but the LEDs are being used across the globe for a variety of applications as far as ornamental lighting and so forth is concerned, or actual lighting. You can see applications like this where a full bit of LED, a number of LEDs, something like 20 to 30 LEDs would go on the bottom of this heat sink. This becomes a carrier plate for it. And as you can see, we've made some designs here in order to make sure that the LED is going to fit into the environment that it's supposed to fit. Here we've provisioned, for instance, holes for the mounting purpose, and the LED board goes in the back side of this. Here is one other example. There are multiplicity of designs and extrusions that are available. If we can focus on the shape of this, you can see that this is a slanted fin with one side cut off, the other side cannot protrude beyond this. But it, because of the cooling requirements and the need that we had for the cooling of the LED and the space, we had to design the heatsink in this fashion.
You shape the heatsink based on what's required for the application.
Exactly. On that note, this is another example of a very, very large extrusion. This is for strip lighting, where the LED is placed on the back side of this extrusion. And you can see the mounting rails to accommodate the attachment of the LED to the back side. And then we have the cooling fins that are placed in order to accommodate the cooling application.
So with this particular one, this the light would fit here, and this would go up kind of in a...
Up in the ceiling or in some other direction, depending upon what the thermal requirements are.
Wait, those lights are pretty hot.
They're very hot and very, very heavy. Here is just another example. You saw the difference, for instance, as far as the fin density and height is concerned between these two fins. If we can focus on these, John, as you can see, this has had a lesser thermal requirement, but this extrusion or this design, because of the fact the thermal requirements are significantly higher, we had to come up with a larger fin and fabricate an extrusion in this fashion in order to be able to do it. So you can just to make a comparison as far as the height is concerned, the height of this extrusion is effectively almost half the length of the other one that you see. These are all designed based on the 150 watts in a natural convection environment.
So
they can get very, very hot, and the application can be demanding depending upon where we can place these LEDs in the final application.
Terrific. Well, these are all the various kinds of LED heat sinks, plus there can be more from ATS. We ask you to come to our website to learn more at qats.com.